serious problem.
It's also understanding of our environment and what we do.
Yeah.
I keep referring to Europe because, of course, I left Ghana when I was about 22 years. So I've stayed longer in Europe than I've stayed in Ghana. And I remember my first time in the university, we went to the prayer meeting. And my Caucasian brothers were praying like this. And I thought, well, this is not what I wanted. It must be audacious. There must be some movement.
Provoke God.
They must be audacious. But when they finished and they started speaking, I realized, oh, wow, they knew what they were about. Then I realized that different setting, different cultures. You'd be surprised. A lot of people don't even understand why we do all night here today. All night has no spirituality. The reason why all night started was the early days of charismatism. Pastor Menzo Otabe was using Baden Power Hall. They rented it. Isaac Kwe was using Social Advance Hall. Almost everybody, including actually, were renting halls and things. You don't have a place to have a space to be able to do church service. The only place you can do it is a school church building after they've closed, and it's only during the Friday night that you have availability. If you are fortunate to have a church, a Methodist church, Presbyterian church, Anglican church building to use, the only time you can use it is in the Friday evening. And that is how all nights began. People think that all night is spirituality. In fact, the witches in the day are dangerous than the witches in the night. So today, you realize that a lot of people are not, and I'm not killing your spiritism, but sometimes it's just a religion. People, they think it is only in the all night. Trust me, I have stopped all night. Because when you go to the all night, in the morning, I cannot go to the weddings, I cannot go to the funerals, I cannot do it. You'll be surprised, you'll be in your clerical collar, and you're seated and you are dozing. Mm-hmm. And people are noticing you. You look so irresponsible because you've come from an all night. And Saturdays is when you do this. So there are a lot of things that we need to just get a mindset to change so we understand the reason why we do certain things. So today, if you truly you have your own church building, then nothing prevents you from having a late evening program. Close late at least and go home instead of the all night. And then also, I'm the first to admit, like Sheikh did, that sometimes we become a nuisance in a community. If your church is in a close community and you're having an all night and you are binding the people. Recently, I was told a church, a particular church, was binding the devil. And a drunkard was next door. He got upset, so he put on some dark cloth and walked into the church. Was a scatter. Everybody was running away. Unfortunately, everybody was running away. The instrument, the pastor, everybody was running away. Unfortunately, there was this Bafine, the cripple there who was sitting there. They said, "Me need nayo. One of them nayo. I'm gonna put
it out." Oh, I like that. He's Bafine.
The people with the feet. I'm gonna put it out. So please, let's learn all. Let us all learn to.
Moderation is the key. Let's keep our community.
Let us not get, and trust me, it's not how loud we become that makes the spirit. It's how much of our heart
I agree.
Is connected to God.
Awesome. So from the